Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video we'll be doing the camera review for this Moto Turbo. And this Moto Turbo is a very interesting handset. The rear facing camera is a 21 megapixel shooter, whereas the front facing camera is just a 2 megapixel shooter. But the good thing is that even with the front facing camera we can record video up to 1080p, whereas with the rear facing camera you can go all the way up to 4K. And I've shot a lot of videos and sample footage with this device. I'll show you that all a bit later, but before that let me quickly give you the camera interface overview. And it's a very simple camera interface, and it launches pretty quickly. And as you can see, we have this option. You can just tap and it focuses, so it's pretty easy to do that. But I would suggest that you enable this option of controlling the exposure, because that this can improve the shots. For example, if we just move this around, you can adjust the exposure, as you can see. And now let's say we have a good exposure, you can tap in and it takes the shots. And I wouldn't say it's the fastest in taking the shots, but after it focuses, it takes the shots pretty quickly. And now let me actually show you the sample shots that I've taken with this device so that you can judge the camera performance. These were shot with the rear facing camera of the Moto Turbo, and as you can see in direct sunlight, the pictures come out to be really sharp and they have good detail. But when I used close up shots like this, as you can see, it had issues focusing. So I would suggest that you stay a little bit away from the subject, that way you can get a lot better shots. Also, in terms of color reproduction, as you can see, it had good color reproduction and good details in the picture. 1080p with the Moto Turbo, to give you an idea how it performs with 1080p video recording. And again, I'm doing this handheld. So do let me know what you feel about the video recording with this Moto Turbo at 1080p. 4K with the Moto Turbo, and the audio that you're hearing is also being recorded by the internal microphone of this device. This Moto Turbo does not have any optical image stabilization, so do let me know what you feel about the video. I'm doing this handheld, and this is my roof garden. I'll just slowly pan now. I wish this device had optical image stabilization. But do let me know what you think about the 4K video quality. And I'm just going to walk back now. It's a little bit windy today, so there might be a bit of wind noise. And it's a bright sunny day today. So this should give you an idea about the video recording.
These pictures were shot in semi-indoor conditions with the Moto Turbo, and here also I would say the Moto Turbo did a very good job. Most cameras have a little bit of problem in this lighting conditions, but here also the Moto Turbo did perform actually pretty well in my opinion. Now these were shot in completely artificial light in my office, and here also I would say the Moto Turbo does a okay job, but you got to be careful. As you can see, this picture was blurry, but when I took it again, it came out clean. And also in low lighting, it can do a decent job, as you can see, but you got to have stable hands. And the biggest problem is the lack of OIS. This was taken without the flash, but here I manually enabled the flash. The rear facing camera provides good amount of detail. As you can see, I zoomed in, then also we have quite a bit of detail in the picture. These pictures were taken with the 2 megapixel front facing camera, and to be frank, I was not that impressed with the front facing camera. The pictures have a lot of noise in them. So what do I feel about the camera performance on this Moto Turbo? As you have seen from the sample shots, the rear facing camera actually does a pretty decent job, and it's a big improvement over earlier Moto devices like the Moto X or even the Moto X2. But again, when we start comparing it with other flagship devices like the iPhone or even the Note 4 or the Samsung Galaxy S6, then the camera, I would say, is just average.
Don't get me wrong, outdoor shots came out actually pretty clean. The biggest problem with this device, I would say, is the lack of optical image stabilization. And due to that, in indoor lighting conditions and sometimes in artificial light, the shots come out to be a little bit blurry. I just don't get it why Motorola omitted the optical image stabilization on this device. But when we move to the video, here I was like thoroughly disappointed. In fact, I would say though it has the 4K video option, the 4K video option, as it does not have optical image stabilization, I would say it was highly unusable. So I would suggest that don't use the 4K option unless you're using a tripod. The 1080p feed was decent, but when we talk about the audio in the video recording, it was hideous. As you might have noticed, there was a lot of wind noise, and even the audio captured when we were shooting the video was simply not acceptable. Also, when we moved to the front facing camera, that is a 2 megapixel shooter, as you have noticed, the quality was simply not that great, considering the fact that the competition has moved a lot ahead even with the front facing cameras. To conclude, I would say the camera on this Moto Turbo is an improvement over earlier Moto devices. The rear facing camera, which is a 21 megapixel shooter, does actually pretty good job in outdoor conditions and also in semi-indoor conditions. But when we talk about video, this Moto Turbo was a big disappointment in my opinion. And Motorola also has to work on the software, because the competition these days offer us a lot more options in the camera department. I'll also be posting the full in-depth review for the Moto Turbo very soon, so stay tuned for that. And if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching this video. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.